Back in Power BI, we continue to learn Power BI Desktop, and in today's video, we are going to show you a very simple technique that allows you to dynamically switch between measures in a visual, and it allows you to use the field parameters function. This is something that came about middle of 2022 into Power BI, the field parameters, and if you have not used field parameters, we will show you how to use them to dynamically. You can choose a set of measures, and then you can create a visual, and then you can select any one of those measures, and the visual will update to that measure. So it allows you to save a little bit of report space. It's a very simple technique, and this is quickly a way to have the user locate the measure that they want to find, and it'll dynamically update to the data that they want to see. So let's go to Power BI. Back in Power BI, we continue to learn Power BI Desktop and DAX. In this video, we're going to work on some reporting techniques, and what we are going to show you how to do very quickly is to dynamically switch visuals with a measure using field parameters. Now, there is going to be a link in the description so you can download this sample file from Microsoft, and we are going to create a parameter, then we are going to create a visual, and then we're going to show you how to dynamically switch visuals with a measure using field parameters. Now, Microsoft does have some sample reports that you can download, and the one that we're going to show you with is called the store sales report. And what this allows you to do is just kind of take a look at what other people are doing in Power BI, give you some ideas for your reports. And this one is very nicely designed. It's got a clean interface. We are going to create a new page. Then we're going to create a parameter, a field parameter, and then we're going to make the decision which measures to use. But basically what this allows you to do is, you see here we have a slicer, and this slicer allows us to select total sales, and now you see total sales by district in the visual. When you select total sales last year, now you see total sales last year, and if you select total units, you see total units by district. So what it does, it allows you to save space. You don't need to create three different visuals. You don't need to create three different slicers. And maybe you put this report out into a Power BI service, and the user, you have different users from different departments. So somebody in the shipping department wants to see the total units, versus the CEO wants to be seeing total sales, or the vice president. So that way they can choose, and it's kind of design your own journey from the user standpoint. So we're going to show you how to dynamically switch this up using a field parameter. Let's show you how to do this. And again, you can download the file. There'll be a link in the description so you can follow along and do this exact tutorial. But if you have your own files already started, if you're new to Power BI and don't have anything to work with, there will be a link in the file below. But if you already have some reports, you can use these field measures to make them a little bit more robust. Let's go to Power BI. Back in Power BI, we are now going to show you how to dynamically switch the visuals with a measure using field parameters. Remember, you can download the file. And what I like about this store sales overview is it already has a very significant number of measures that you can use for either reporting techniques or creating some additional visuals. And if you're new to Power BI and you want to learn more about reports and building reports, these give you some good ideas. They show you some color schemes, all the different visual options. The first thing we are going to do is create a new page at the bottom of the visual, and we're just going to call this dynamic visuals. Then if you go to the modeling view, The first thing you need to do is create the parameter. And you'll see this section, it says new parameter. And you want to choose between one of the two options. You have numeric range parameters and you have field parameters. So we're going to choose the field parameter option. And this asks for a couple of different names. One, it's going to ask for the fields, and then it's going to ask for the name. So for the name, we are going to have dynamic visual as our name. And now it's going to ask you to add the different measures that you want to be able to choose from. And in this example, we are going to add total sales. We are going to add total sales last year, and then we're going to add total units. Now you can reorder these as well. So if you want to reorder, have total units be first, you could have that. And then the only other option that you're going to want to select is this add slicer to this page. That is what's going to automatically build that slicer. The name of the parameter is going to be dynamic visual, and we're going to have three measures to choose from. Next, you just close this out by hitting the create button. Now, if you notice on the right-hand side, we now have a parameter slicer called dynamic visual. And the option inside there is dynamic visual. And that's the one we're going to use. That is the slicer you see on the page. You've got total units, you've got total sales, and you've got total sales last year. What this allows you to do now is you can create a visual. The second part of the process is to create a visual, and we're going to use the bar chart. And all it's going to need now is on the x-axis, we're going to choose the district. So that is going to be the x-axis. Now on the y-axis, we're going to choose from the dynamic visual that we created, we're going to choose this dynamic visual. And now we see that everything graphs out. Now, the one thing we do have to change is in this visual, we need to go to the build a visual and go to the size and style. And we need to change one thing. We need to have for the parameter is for the slicer. Under the slicer settings, for the selection, we want to turn on single select. Otherwise, it's going to use all of the different options in the chart. So when we turn this on, now we see total sales last year, we see total units, and we see total sales. Now we're just going to clean this up a little bit. One thing we may want to do to make this title stick out a little bit more is we are going to make this 12 point. We're going to make this bold. And we're going to make this black. So now when we select total sales last year, it clearly identifies what we're looking at by the district. And then on this dynamic slicer, we are going to change just a couple of quick things on it. You know, we have the values. We're going to make them a little bit bigger. And we're going to turn off the name of the visual that we created for the slicer. So now the user can just go in here. They can select total units. They now see total units by district. They can select total sales. They see total sales by district. And they can select total sales last year. And you only had to create one visual. and we only had to create one dynamic field parameter. So that is a look at how to use field parameters. Again, this is new to Power BI, and it saves time because you only have to create one visual, you only have to create one parameter, and it also creates space on the report page. If you want to keep this to a smaller report, you can do that by dynamically switching between visuals. So in this video, we showed you how to quickly create a visual, create a field parameter, and then dynamically switch visuals with a measure using that field parameter. And it was a three-step process. The easiest way to kind of think about it is three steps. First, you create the parameter, and you want to make sure it's a field parameter. Then you want to name that parameter. Remember, that is in the modeling section, new parameter and field parameter. Then you want to create a visual. In this visual, we went to the home menu, and from the visual gallery, we selected the bar chart. And then the final step, once you brought in the slicer into the visual under the y-axis, what you needed to do is adjust that slicer to a single select. So that way, when you choose whichever measure you're choosing, is the only measure that shows up in the visual. We recently did another visual on dynamically changing measures in a visual. This one, we use a slicer to create a parameter, and then we can change which unit we want to see, which measure we want to see in the visual. Remember to share, like, and subscribe to the channel as we continue to do more videos on Power BI and learning marketing techniques in Power BI.